So, bache, almost our syllabus is done. Only some of the extra questions of If I Were You, this play were left. So, we will be able to complete it today. And from tomorrow onwards, our revision will be started. So, from tomorrow notebook, from tomorrow onwards, you all should have a separate notebook with you for revision, because whatever writing skills, whatever grammar, whatever literature, what is being revised in class, if you will keep all the notes at one place, so during your exam preparation, you will not find any kind of difficulty. Because at a glance, you'll be able to understand the grammar rules. At a glance, you'll be able to see at your mistakes. You can rectify them. You can learn from your mistakes. So in order to be organized, you are a student of 9th class. In order to be organized, it's better that you all should have a separate notebook. I'm not saying to you to purchase a new notebook. If you have any old notebook of any of the subject of previous class, you can staple the used pages, and unused pages you can use for English revision. It is your wish. And if you really want to purchase a new one, it is your wish. There is not a compulsion, but separate record should be there of revision. Why so? For your convenience. So tomorrow I will be taking a round. I will be seeing that you people have followed my guidelines or not. You have brought separate notebook or not. So it will be seen, and your names will be announced here. Defaulters' names. Will be seen. So now from that play, If I Were You, I'm going to give you some extra questions. Extra question. Bachche, I'm going to give you some of the extra questions. You take one by one and start writing. We'll be discussing it in the class. So write down. See, I'm going to over this class to you. I will be telling extra questions of Bruno. So strange class is this. You can ask this thing to your classmates, or you should ask me. So you see the video recording. See their smartness. How do they interrupt the teacher? And they're a student of 9th class. Laksh Jarath, you haven't written extra question, Bruno. हाँ लिखे हुए यू हैवन रिटन बिकॉज इट इज हिज हैबिट टू डिस्टर्ब सो राइट डाउन दिस क्वेश्चन व्हाई डिड जिराड से Why did Gerard say the intruder a sympathetic audience? What was the reason behind that? Why this dialogue, why this phrase was spoken by Gerard, a sympathetic audience? I'm going to explain this answer, but before that, I just want to see your knowledge, how much proficient, how much knowledgeable, how much intelligent you people are. From online class, Dhiren is raising his hand. Dhiren is always attentive in my class. His answers are always ready. What about offline? Arvind, this is a last warning. Otherwise, there'll be a great insult for you. A sympathetic audience. From offline only, Simran. From online, Dhiren, and from offline, Simran. What about others? What about others? Your cartoon network, you know, is going to be over very soon. Thank you. Okay, Simran, you tell me. It's better that you come here. After Simran, I will be asking Dhiren, and then I will be telling you about your performance, that how are you performing in class. Whole of the chapter is done. Back exercise question answers are done, and they are not able to tell the meaning of sympathetic audience. Only three or two.
Gerard said this at last to sympathetic audience. He said that as a reaction to the question of intruder who asks him to speak about himself, and Gerard is sarcastic about it and he doesn't took it seriously.
When I was explaining the play, I told you to make fun. Okay. Whatever Simran has spoken, it was right, but we have to elaborate this answer in detail. Okay, now I'm giving a chance to Dhiren. Dhiren, what have you written?
Yes, ma'am. Gerard said the intruder's sympathetic audience, as the intruder asked him to tell about himself. And as Gerard lived alone for a long time, he wasn't able to tell his story. Actually, Gerard was trying to keep himself calm and sarcastic to disguise his fear and not to make things serious.
Yes. First thing that you have to keep in your mind, that he was in panic, but he wanted to conceal his, you can say, condition from that intruder. So that's why he was using sarcasm. Whatever the dialogue he was speaking, he was using these dialogue using sarcasm. He was making fun, but internally he was also afraid. He was in panic. Okay. But in his conversation, he was not pretending that he was in panic. So first point that you have to keep in your mind is that he was pretending only. Okay. He was using the content of sarcasm. Okay. In order to, you can say, pretend. He doesn't want to reveal that he was in panic. Clear? So you just tell me the intention of people. See, people always avoid listening to the talks of others. It happens with us also sometimes. People, they avoid listening to the talk of others. Okay? They would be only interested in their own matters. Isn't it? It happens with you or not? Yes, suppose any of your friend is very much willing to tell something happened yesterday. In between, you will interrupt and you will say, no, it happened with me yesterday. It happens sometime. Okay. So you can add up this point also, that people are always in the habit of avoiding listening to others. They are in the habit of telling matters of themselves. Okay. So when the intruder was showing his willingness, when intruder was showing his willingness to listen to the words of Gerard, when intruder was showing his willingness that he wanted to listen to the words of Gerard. So what was saying? He spoke sympathetic audience. Why sympathetic audience? Because he was having no choice. He had to listen. Okay. So Gerard said so with another intention. His intention was to divert his attention. His intention was to divert his attention. That's why he spoke these phrases. This phrase. That's why this phrase was spoken, that so that his plan could come out. Okay, what was the planning which was going in his mind? It could come out. So that's why he spoke like that, sympathetic audience, only to divert his attention. Clear? So you write down all these points that I have told you, add up your points also, then frame your answer in a nice way. Clear, bachche? Now shall I move to next question?
Yes, ma'am.
What was the special area of crime for the intruder? Why did he come there to Essex? So, what was the special area of crime? Tell me. Intruder was a thief?
Yes.
In which area he told that he was? Area you can say, in which kind of thing he was doing? Yes. So here, what was the special area of crime for the intruder? Special area of crime. It means he was not a simple thief. He was not a, you can say, he was doing stealing of simple things. He used to do professional robbery. In which he has taken degree? Huh? His special area was that he was a jewel robber. He used to do robbery of a jewelry. Okay.
Code number 36 and 41.
Kaun hai 26?
Present,
roll
number 25, present.
Yes.
Yes.
He follow up with Chandi. Roll number 42.
Who is 42?
Simran. 43 years.
मैं कलेक्ट करवा देती हूँ। 25 ईयर 42 कौन है? हाँ? It is a very simple answer I have given you. You start framing in your words. I'm going to see what you people have written. Just let me see what you people have written. Okay, now your answer is framed. Who is going to tell me this answer? Yes? Who is going to tell me this answer? Hurry up. Okay, Pranshi, have you written? Lakshi, have you written this answer? Renuka, come. Tell me this answer. इधर आओ इसके सामने. Okay, now this Sudiksha, you come and read. Lonely.
Isolated.
Speak.
But first he told that he came to retire from the profile as the cops were behind him or the cops were in search of him. But then he told that he came to kill Gerard and to steal his identity.
Okay. So basically the question is you have to tell about his profession. Okay. So what was his profession?
Jewel robber.
Hariyab, have you framed this in answer?
Yes, ma'am.
So his main profession was to rob jewels. Okay? And there were hardly any jewels in that place. But he came in that place in order to avoid cops. In order to avoid police so that he could conceal himself there. He could hide himself there. Okay? And at this place, he's committed. Yes. So now write down next question. So the thing is that you have to tell about his profession. So his profession was very simple. What was that? Jewel robbery. Ma'am is waiting for you outside. Give your notebooks to her. This is. Keep it in between. English notebooks should be kept in between. अपने बाकी दे दो वो रहने दो बाकी दे दो बस इंग्लिश को मेरे घर जाएगी डोंट डिस्टर्ब माय क्लास गिव योर नोटबुक्स टू दैट मैम See, his intention was not to go. Ma'am is waiting for you. Give your note. Please let me teach. Ma'am is waiting for you. So he was master in doing the jewel robbery. Okay. And his intention was not to go at the place. अब ये दे दो बस. तो मैम प्लीज डोंट डिस्टर्ब. Take of 26. These are checked ना. हाँ then give. So मैम we come to know about your performance also. So there were hardly any. Dwells in Essex, but he went there because he made a plan to hide himself from, he wanted to escape from the cops. Okay,